So far, we have covered all semi-regular polyhedra, but there are many less symmetric convex polyhedra that can be created from regular polygons, such as this square pyramid, a dodecahedron with a pyramid built on one side, or this strange shape. In 1966, American mathematician Norman Johnson published a paper listing 92 such polyhedra. But it wasn't until 3 years later that Russian mathematician Viktor Zalgaller proved the list was complete. These 92 have become known as the Johnson solids. All but 9 of the Johnson solids can be constructed by cutting up and joining together semi-regular polyhedra. The first two are simply parts of platonic solids. Half an octahedron is a square pyramid, the first Johnson solid. The cap of an icosahedron is a pentagonal pyramid, Johnson solid number 2. The next 4 are parts of Archimedean solids. Half a cube octahedron gives us J3. This is called the triangular cupola. It has a triangle at the top and a hexagon at the bottom, connected by a ring of triangles and squares. The top of a rhombicube octahedron is a square cupola, like the triangular cupola, but with a square and an octagon. The top of a rhombicosidodecahedron is a pentagonal cupola. Finally, half an icosidodecahedron gives us this lovely shape, called a pentagonal rotunda. We now look at extending the pyramids by adding other shapes. We include the triangular pyramid amongst these, although it is not itself a Johnson solid, being a platonic tetrahedron. We can add a prism to the triangular pyramid to make an elongated triangular pyramid. And similarly, for the square pyramid and pentagonal pyramid. Alternatively, an antiprism can be added to make a gyro-elongated square pyramid and gyro-elongated pentagonal pyramid. The gyro-elongated triangular pyramid isn't convex, so isn't included. We can join pyramids back to back to make a triangular bipyramid and pentagonal bipyramid. The square bipyramid is an octahedron, which is a platonic solid, so isn't a Johnson solid. Then there are 3 elongated bipyramids, triangular, square, and pentagonal. And also a gyro-elongated square pyramid. We exclude the gyro-elongated triangular bipyramid because it is concave. And also exclude the gyro-elongated pentagonal bipyramid because it's a platonic icosahedron. We can do similar things with the cupolas and rotunda. We have 3 elongated cupolas. The elongated pentagonal rotunda. 3 gyro-elongated cupolas. And the gyro-elongated rotunda. For back-to-back cupolas and rotunda, we start with the exotically named gyro-bifastigium, which is made from 2 triangular prisms. This might at first glance look out of place, but the triangular prism can be thought of as a type of cupola with a square base surrounded by alternating squares and triangles and an imaginary diagon at the top. Other back-to-back cupolas and rotunda come in 2 types. If triangles are joined to triangles, the prefix ortho is used, such as the triangular ortho bicupola. But if triangles are joined to squares, gyro is used, such as the triangular gyro bicupola. But this is in fact an Archimedean cube octahedron, so we discard it. Square and pentagonal ortho bicupolas and gyro bicupolas are valid. pentagonal cupola and pentagonal rotunda both have decagonal bases, so can be joined to each other. So we have the pentagonal orthocupola rotunda and the pentagonal gyrocupola rotunda. Then the pentagonal orthobirotunda, the pentagonal gyrobirotunda is an icosidodecahedron, so we discard it. There are several elongated back-to-back versions. The elongated square orthobicupola is the Archimedean rhombicube octahedron, so not included. The elongated square gyrobicupola is the famous pseudo-rhombicube octahedron, which has its own video. And there are five gyro-elongated solids. These last five are the only Johnson solids that do not have mirror symmetry, so they each have a left-handed and a right-handed version. There then follows a series of augmentations, which are solids created by adding shapes on faces of semi-regular solids. First, we can add a square pyramid to one side of a triangular prism to get an augmented triangular prism. If we build a pyramid on two sides, we get a bi-augmented triangular prism. And if on all three sides, we get a tri-augmented triangular prism. This is a deltahedron. All its faces are triangles. A pentagonal prism can be augmented on one or two sides. A hexagonal prism can be augmented on one, two, or three sides. The bi-augmented hexagonal prism has two variants. If opposite sides are augmented, it's called a para-bi-augmented hexagonal prism. If non-opposite sides are augmented, it's called a meta-bi-augmented hexagonal prism. A dodecahedron can be augmented with a pentagonal pyramid on one side, on two opposite sides, on two non-opposite sides, or on three sides. The icosahedron can be diminished, which means having a pentagonal pyramidal cap removed. A diminished icosahedron is the same as the gyro-elongated pentagonal pyramid, and a parabi-diminished icosahedron is just a pentagonal antiprism. But the meta-bi-diminished icosahedron is a new shape. And so is the tri-diminished icosahedron. Furthermore, the tri-diminished icosahedron can be augmented with a tetrahedron. A truncated tetrahedron can be augmented with a triangular cupola. A truncated cube can be augmented or augmented on two opposite sides with square cupolas. And a truncated dodecahedron can be augmented, parabi-augmented, metabi-augmented, or tri-augmented with pentagonal cupolas. The rhombicosidodecahedron is more complicated. Up to three pentagonal cupola caps can be rotated. But caps can also be diminished. And rotations and diminishments can be combined. In all, there are 12 variants of the rhombacosito dodecahedron. There are a further 9 Johnson solids which can't be constructed from semi-regular polyhedra. The snub-dice sphenoid is a deltahedron with 12 faces. The snub-square antiprism is 2 halves of a square antiprism separated by a ring of triangles. The sphenocorona is a pair of adjacent squares with a complex of 12 triangles. A pyramid can be built on one square of this to make an augmented sphenocorona. The sphenomegacorona is similar to the sphenocorona, but with a larger complex of 16 triangles. The hebisphenomegacorona consists of 3 adjacent squares with a complex of triangles. The disphenosingulum is 2 pairs of adjacent squares separated by a belt of triangles. The bilunar birotunda is 2 sections of pentagonal rotundas alternating with 2 lunes, squares with 2 triangles attached. And finally, Johnson solid number 92 is the triangular hebisphenorotunda, with a larger section of pentagonal rotunda on one side and a hexagon on the other. That's it for this video. Please consider giving it a like if you enjoyed it, and see you next time.